أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، ولا سيما سيدنا محمد المصطفى صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله أهل الصفا، ورضي الله عن أزواجه وذرياته وأصحابه وأحبابه، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. There is plenty of ayahs in the fifth juz that were covered, obviously, especially in Surah An-Nisa. Among one of the ayahs that obviously has an authentic hadith in it is also in Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 40. Where Allah says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَٰؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. And the meaning of the ayah is, how is it when we bring a witness, or someone who witnesses, someone who testifies, someone who is has been a standard or a benchmark in a sense, and an ummah. We bring from every ummah someone who testifies, who's a witness on what happened, and then we bring you as a witness, as a shaheed on everyone. And the hadith says that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, you know Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was one of the qurra, or one of the ulama of the qira'ah. Yani if you can argue that the ilm or ulum al-Qur'an go to two people amongst the senior Sahaba, would go to Ali ibn Abi Talib, would go to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, both of them have an authentic narrations to say, ask me about any ayah in the Quran, but I'll tell you where it is and when was it revealed and all that, right? So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the authentic hadith, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, "Ya, why don't you read the Quran for me?" قَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ You want me to read it for you, and it was revealed unto you? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, I like to hear it from other than me. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud reads and reads and reads until he comes to this ayah here, number 40. فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ How about when we bring from every nation, from every group, someone who's a witness? Witness on the right, on the wrong, witness that he taught, and etc. and all that. And وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَٰؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا And you become then the witness or the standard of all. And he says, I looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his eyes were watering and he was weeping sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَوَدُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا Allah says, at that day, those who have covered the truth, and no kufr, don't always reduce it to just disbelief. Kufr in its origin, the linguistic origin, is those who cover the truth. And obviously disbelieving is covering the truth. Allah says, which means that day those who cover the truth, وعصوا الرسول, and they actually disobeyed the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would love if they were equal. لو تسوى بهم الأرض They would rather that they were equal to the soil of earth. Right? وَلَا يَكْتُمُونَ اللَّهَ حَدِيثًا And they would not withhold anything that's righteous from Allah Azza wa Jalla, يعني, or before Allah. And then the ayah goes, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارًا O you who believe, do not come to the salah, or do not approach the salah while you are intoxicated, drunk. And obviously there's an ishari meaning here that's very obvious, which means if Allah Azza wa Jalla is asking us not to approach the salah while our body is contaminated with impurity, you can imagine that the priority would be that do not approach the salah while your heart is contaminated with impurity, because the cleansing of the heart is much more prioritized than the cleansing of the body in the salah. And therefore, yani clean your body, or clean your body before your salah, and also clean the heart as well before you come to the salah. And that's very important, I think. So a lot of people just leave it on the issue of alcohol and they don't realize that the Quran is always sending lots of dimensions there. Also, another. There's many. I don't know which one to really just cover. Go over here. Another ayah here, Allah Azza wa Jal says, tells us in Surah Nisa, still, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُم بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. Allah commands you that you actually, when you are entrusted, that you actually hold on to that trust, yani that you don't betray that trust. And when you, if you are to mediate or if you're to give judgment among people, then make sure that you're doing fairly. And Allah Azza wa Jal warns and preaches in that sense, yani in ya'idhukum bih, inna Allah kana sami'an basira, Allah hears all and sees all. And then Allah Azza wa Jal tells us in the next ayah, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ati'u Allah wa ati'u ar-rasul wa uli al-amri minkum. Obey Allah, obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those in charge of your affairs righteously. So, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ, if you disagree about something, فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ, you should bring it back to the Qur'an and the Sunnah if you believe in Allah, or if you believe at all, bring it back to Allah and bring it back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore Allah Azza wa Jal then gives us in the next ayah an example and draws a contrast between, he says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. Don't you see about those who claim that they believe in what has been revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what has been revealed to those prophets before you? يُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَحَاكَمُوا إِلَى الطَّاغُوتِ. What they want to do is they want to peddle their falsehood by actually seeking judgment by falsehood from falsehood, not from the way of the prophets, not from the way of the Quran. وَقَدْ أُمِرُوا أَن يَكْفُرُوا بِهِ, and they were actually commanded to disbelieve in that and not seek that evil. وَيُرِيدُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَن يُضِلَّهُمْ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا, and shaitan wishes to take them even more distant and more far and more far and more far and more far. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ, and notice it's a total diagnostic almost. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ, and if you tell them, why don't we come and sit and talk about based on the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and based on the way Allah Azza wa Jal revealed, why don't we agree to that? What do they, what Allah say? رأيت المنافقين يصدون عنك صدودا, you would see the munafiqeen exactly going the other way. فكيف إذا أصابتهم مصيبة بما قدمت أيديهم, and how about when calamities befall them, etc. And that's also a reminder and a warning for all. And then the ayahs continue where Allah says, أولئك الذين يعلم الله ما في قلوبهم, those are يعني the منافقين, يا رسول الله, Allah knows what's in their hearts. فأعرض عنهم, avoid them, يعني Allah knows, don't worry about that, avoid them. But عظهم, if you have the chance to remind them, remind them. وقل لهم في أنفسهم قولا بليغا, and if you have the opportunity to privately tell them the truth that they are munafiqeen. Tell them the truth that they are liars, and tell them the truth that they are forgers, and tell them the truth that there will be consequences for what they do. But fi anfusihim, privately. And from this ayah we can take also that an-nasiha, or giving advice, is never public, really, to be honest with you. If the sincere advice, as Allah says, وَقُلْ لَهُمْ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ, tell them privately. Because if the nasiha is really for Allah's sake, it cannot be public, because if it's public, it's really slander. But if it is private, then you're trying to give them a firm message, and without any cosmetics, without any lies, without going extremes above or beyond, but exactly as is, and you're delivering your amana. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. We've sent the messengers, but that they are followed, they are obeyed, that people take their path as the path of life, not the path of shayateen as the path of life. وَلَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And then the ayah here, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ. And had they, when they have wronged themselves, come to you, Ya Rasulullah, فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهِ, and they seek forgiveness from Allah, وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولِ, and the Rasul seeks forgiveness on their behalf from Allah, لَوَجَدُوا اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا, they would surely find Allah all forgiving and granting them, accepting their repentance. Ash-Shawkani rahimahullah al-Qadi says, who died 1250 Hijra in his Fath al-Qadir, he says that this ayah also, as after the prophetic departure, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yani the one had they, when they have wronged themselves, when the believer wronged themselves, they come to you and they seek, yani they come and they seek istighfar from Allah, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes istighfar for them, they would surely find Allah all forgiving and all merciful. So Allah Azza wa Jal forgive us with that as well. And this is consistent with the hadith of Al-Bazzar and Abdullah bin Mas'ud, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is narrated to have said, Hayati khayrun lakum wa mamati khayrun lakum. My life is good for you, and when I depart is also good for you. Tu'radu alayya a'malukum. Your deeds are shown to me. فَإِنْ رَأَيْتُ خَيْرًا حَمَدْتُ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى. If I see good, I thank Allah Azza wa Jal. And if I see other than that, استغفرتُ لَكُمْ. I seek forgiveness from you. So if what Al-Shawkani said and others is also valid after the prophetic departure sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then that also shows you the significance of visiting Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal grant us that honor, right? And then the ayahs go further, and Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رَفِيقًا. And I'll finish with this here, because really there are plenty of ayahs here that we can stop at. But this ayah says, which means whoever obeys Allah and His Rasul, those will be with those whom Allah graced. Graced, whom are those who أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ? You say it also, for example, in your Fatiha, you say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Who are those who are, Ya Allah, the path of those you've graced? Who are those you've graced? أنعمت عليهم. Allah defines them here in Surah النساء, من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. والصالحين. يعني when you're saying in your Fatiha, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, Ya Allah, give me the right path, the path of those you have graced. Well, who are those that Allah graced Azza wa Jal? Are النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. And what a great company this is. The company of the نبيين, the company of the صديقين, the truthful people. Obviously, you say, all right, the company of the نبيين, how can we be in the company of the نبيين? Well, we can be in the company of their sunnah. We can live in the shades of their lives, عليهم الصلاة والسلام. We can live on the fragrance that emanates from mentioning them, and almost living with them day by day when we understand their lives. How about the Siddiqeen? Also, Lamiyyin Siddiqeen. Well, those that comes from Siddiq, those people who say the truth, those people who are truthful in their thoughts, truthful in their mu'amala with other people, truthful with Allah Azza wa Jal, truthful with the creation. And you know, and people like those who are truthful, وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ, and the shuhada obviously, and the pious people, صَالِحِينَ. In the old days, people always, and when parents made dua for their children, they always, or others made dua for children or for young ones, they've always said, may Allah make them among the صَالِحِينَ. And today they say, may Allah give him that good job there, and may Allah give him this thing there. And you know, you see how the dua has changed. And we got the jobs, but the salah we haven't yet. Maybe Allah Azza wa Jalla, not all of us, maybe some of us have, alhamdulillah, or most of us. Lakin the issue here is as-salihin is an important thing, that we make dua for ourselves and each other, that Allah makes us amongst the salihin, the righteous people, the good people. Good people. That requires dua and requires action, both. And the story behind this this verse, whoever obey, which means whoever obeys Allah and His Rasul, they will be assembled with the Nabiyeen and the Siddiqeen, the Shuhada and the Saliheen, and what a good company it is the Thawban, Mawla Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Thawban, Al-Qurtubi narrates this, the hadith, the narration is weak, but not too weak. So Thawban seems to be frail and seems to be almost sick. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells him, what's with you, Ya Thawban? Qal Ya Rasulullah, he tells him, Ya Rasulullah, when we are with you, we feel so good and we are so blessed. And when we go to our family and children and wife and all that, I have a longing for you, Ya Rasulullah, and longing to be in your company, that I don't know what to, so it makes me not enjoy anything. It makes me not want to be with anything. It makes me almost sick until I come and see you, Ya Rasulullah. So this is the kind of love that Sayyidina Thawban radiallahu anhu had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the narration says that Thawban was crying or frail, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam assures him that you are with me here. And Thawban is saying, telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, allegedly, but I'm not worried about here. Here, as long as we live in the dunya, when we miss you, we come and see you and we are in your company. But I am worried about Jannah or about the Akhirah. If I do make it to Jannah, look at how Thawban is thinking now. If I do make it to Jannah, then you will be with the Nabiyeen, and the Nabiyeen at the highest level of Jannah. And if Thawban makes it in Jannah, Thawban will make it at barely, maybe, right? He says then Thawban allegedly is crying radiallahu anhu because he can't be in the prophetic presence or in the prophetic company sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam when he is in the Akhirah in Jannah. And this is when Al-Qurtubi says, yani, the ayah was revealed, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ, whoever obeys Allah and obeys the Rasul, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, they will be assembled with those whom Allah graced, such as the Nabiyeen and the Siddiqeen and the Shuhada and the Salihin, وَحَسُنَا أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا, and what a good company this is. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us in that company. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَآلِهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.